Hello again. I know it's been a while, but we'll be talking about process last here. My mic broke, and now I've got a new one, so hopefully this will sound better, and it'll be an altogether more pleasurable auditory experience. Unlike previous videos, I'm not going to go over sticky traps and hiding spots. I just don't. This video is going to take a little bit of time because I'm going to do it a little bit differently. I'm not going to have as much me walking around on a map fraxing stuff as I talk about it, and a little bit more text, in part because it's quicker to render that, and I think it gives you some more of the meat and potatoes of why you do certain things. But anyways, we'll get started here. Perhaps uniquely for every map in the competitive rotation right now, it is incredibly easy to push off of process last. So, whereas in some other videos I haven't really talked about it very much as to where you should be holding in preparation for a push, on this map it's much more important because if somebody screws up and dies, you could be hearing from the enemy team very quickly and losing second. So I'll show two different holds that you can use in order to not lose your second while you're trying to push last. Or getting ready to, at least. So this is the first hold. This is a preferable hold. You've got your pocket on the doorway, the upper doorway to the lobby. Your roamer's on top of the little ledge that comes out from there. Your medic's in an area I like to call, for purposes of this, the safety cupboard. And that's just with his back to the wall in IT, the entranceway to IT. And then you've got a scout standing on the ramp between one and two doors. You've got a scout standing on the little bridge to the point proper, and a demo standing on the point. What this is aiming to do is it's really hard for them to push out from basically anywhere. I also show where your demo should put some traps down that are really common. Just make it hard to push for them in general. And try not to get killed. You'll also see in this arrangement, it's relatively easy for everybody to get buffed. Because the medic just has to walk around. The biggest thing here is you've got to stay out of sniper sight lines, especially as medic, and keep your back to the wall. Because if you don't, you're going to get stabbed, potentially. Now this is sort of the back hold for... if you believe you have made a mistake and they're about to push out on you, or somehow or another you just caught them with their pants down and they had to leave second for whatever reason, and now they've got six players and Uber and you don't have Uber, they may attempt to push out on you, and this is the best way to go about holding for that. You've got your combo on the little pipes leading up. To the upper exit to IT. They just chill out there. Your demo's right there beside them with the sticky trap anywhere forward to kill them maybe when they come out. And then you have your roamer and both scouts a little bit forward, and all they're there to do, your scouts in particular, is if they try to jump someone onto the spire, your scouts just kill them and run away. And your roamer puts foot down forward spam, and if they don't pop immediately, he has to jump on them and get them to pop. Here I'm going to show pictures of one and two door, which are doors that you should never ever push through unless you've got massive player or Uber advantage, preferably both. Those two doors exist solely to push through in the event that you've, like, wiped them at mid, your whole team's up, everybody's alive. You send your soldier, demo, and medic through to last as scouts cap second. Like, that's really the only time that you can push through one and two door and have it not be a complete disaster. Or if they try to defend Spire and do a really crappy job of it and lose four people or something, then you can push through those doors. But otherwise, you're just going to die to a sniper or a sticky trap or get blocked to the point where you can't push. So don't use these doors ever, ever, ever unless you've got a huge advantage. So now we're going to talk about actually pushing last. And there's essentially an A or B question you should ask yourself. Do we have advantage in Uber or do we not? I'm going to talk about what you should do first if you have the Uber advantage. You'll want to use 3 and 4 doors, which I'll show pictures of here. You don't want to use 5-door as much as you might in other times, because when you push through there, generally there's only going to be 1 or 2 people there, and they're separated from their team's medic, maybe. And if you find that to be the case, they're easy kills. But the problem is if you're pushing off of a smaller Uber advantage, you may just let them get Uber. And because you usually send in a lot of people when you have Uber advantage, that could really bite you. So ideally, when you've got advantage, if they're close, you're going to do what's called a chariot Uber. And that's going to be 2 scouts. You're just, if they're really close to you and you've got advantage, just Uber 2 scouts on them, kill everybody really quickly, and bring in your pocket behind your 2 scouts. Or you can, if they're really, really far away, you can bring in both soldiers and your demo, and that just puts really heavy spam on them. You would want to use the 2 soldiers demo alignment or arrangement when they're on bats, the very back end of last, because you're going to have to do a lot of jumps and stuff to get to them. If they're on the ground, then you could use your scout Uber, as long as they don't have anything like a sentry gun set up. It'd also be particularly effective against a heavy on the ground. If you answer that you don't have Uber advantage, then you need to figure out a way to figure things out. And what you're going to do is run a suicide. The suicide's goal should be to pop their Uber. Likely not going to happen. And then you have that person come back as an off class when they respawn. Now, I'm going to talk about what kind of suicide you can run. A one-man suicide would typically just be your roamer bombing in, or maybe a scout trying to sort of sneak in and get a pick. That's the safest thing to do if they're holding close on you. Because on process, if you go even a player down and they're really close to the doors on their own last, they will take second away from you if you don't pop their Uber or get a pick. If they're really far away and they've got an engineer or a heavy that's not very close to the spawn door, then you can maybe suicide in 2 or 3 players to get the pop out. And in that case, there's really no way that they can hold the Uber through that. But you risk losing second. The closer they are to the doors, the riskier it is. So in general, you just see a roamer bomb or a scout sneak, and then that's about it, because it's so dangerous. So now we'll talk about off-classing, which after you suicide, you come back with your off-class. What you're going to try to do with your off-class is to either even the fight or get a pick. So you've got 4 viable ones for process, with pyro being a little questionable. Heavy, spy, sniper, and pyro. I'll show a little video of what to do as each. So the first we're going to talk about here is Mr. Hoovy, and you'll put him on the spire just to protect against being pushed on, and then eventually have him just follow up the combo. And I like going lower personally. Just make sure you check for a sticky trap above your head. Then your team pushes in, you wait, and you basically just eyeball 3 and 4 door. Hopefully your team will tell you whether 4 side or 3 side is closer. Then your medic will come meet you. You get your 450 and you kill everybody. A notable thing about this point as well is that the rails on either side block projectiles. So if a soldier tries to splash you by hitting the ground, staying behind the rails will pretty much result in an assured defeat for him. So we've got Sniper Man, and what you're going to do with Sniper, it's best for you to respawn and come through the IT side. Then you need to sneak to whichever position you're going to, make sure you're not seen, and then you scope in against this wall here if you're going to snipe through 2-door, and slowly peek through, taking care to hide your dot and try and shoot the medic or anyone important. A demo man is really good as well. Heavy pocket soldier. Same deal up here, is you can just peek around up here. You can also charge against this doorway and look this way. The thing about looking left from the stairway here is you need to have somebody covering your right side, because you're going to have your back turned and you don't want to get headshot yourself, because a lot of teams will run a sniper against you. The other more popular option as well is to look through five door, and you just do your typical thing here. There should be someone like right in your face too that you could get an easy shot on. Plus, you get a pretty good view of everywhere else. Now we're going to talk about Spy Man. The first thing you need to do as Spy Man is to disguise yourself as a friendly sniper. Be crafty. Then give someone a view of you. Haha, I'm a sniper, you will say. And then they'll go, oh no, they're running a sniper. And they'll do something stupid like run their own sniper. And then that's when you disguise as a scout, or generally just a scout. And then in America, you can use the cloak and dagger. So this is sort of my favorite C&D route, because it's hard for people to see you. If you're running regular InvisWatch, you just have to beeline it up onto the bats here. Also with C&D, you can crouch walk to have it deplete slower. Then once you get up into the panic room, this would apply also for a regular spy. You just use the window to kind of scope out your target. Then you call for your team to provide a distraction, so your pocket soldier will peek out. Maybe your roamer will come in and jump around like an idiot. Something, some distraction. And then that's when you make your move and backstab all the people on the team. And everybody says how good you are. And if you're casted, the caster will catch it right on stream if they're any good. With Pyro, you basically just come in, blow the stickies off the point, and then try and corral their combo into the corner of one part of the map. That's really all there is to it. And it can be super effective if it's not expected. So to review, here are some steps for last. First, move into lobby. Find out where their combo is standing. Suicide for an off class or uber pop if you are at even or uber disadvantage. Push in three players plus your medic if you have advantage, pushing only the pocket if the ubers are even. This doesn't apply to the 1 and 2 door push that I talked about earlier. There you're going to uber in three people in total, usually your pocket or the roamer and a demo, and the medic, of course. And then that'll just lock them in spawn as they're respawning, and then you're good to go. And then, as soon as the ubers are over, on every push, a scout must suicide on the point. It'll make your KD look bad, but stats don't win games in most cases. And the way you do that is it should either be arranged ahead of time which scout is going to suicide on the point, or during the push, a scout should yell, "I got it," like they're playing baseball, and just go die on the point. You do not want more than one person to suicide for the point, because that's just silly. You could also have your med suicide for the point, but I really only like doing that if you've managed to get three kills. Two or three kills, then you can drop the med instead of a combat class, but that's pretty dangerous, especially on this map. Whereas in previous videos, I kind of just walked around by myself and then frapsed sort of me talking about different ideas. I think it might be better if I just do a text-based breakdown of what each class's goals are for pushing last. And this could apply universally, almost. So now we'll talk about scouts on last. If the enemy is very close and you have uber advantage, you and your scout buddy should be getting ubered together in the chariot uber format. If you have advantage, but the enemy isn't very close, so they're doing what most teams do, standing on the bats, one of you should be ready to follow in the pocket, the medic, and the demo, or whoever else, whatever you've decided to go with for your Uber. And you will come in after all of the rest of them are in. That way you don't take the entry spam or risk a sticky trap. Don't try and run through the door all at once. And if they do have a pyro, then you're going to have to lead the Uber because you're just going to kill the pyro right away. Or make them Uber a pyro. And at that point, as soon as they Uber the pyro, they have lost. So there's that for you. And one of the scouts must die on the point. In general, I like that being the scout that went with the Uber. It's easiest for him to do that. The other scout kind of will guard the demo. If it's Uber v Uber and you're just bringing in your pocket, one of your scouts is in charge of guarding the demo. And so he's really not going to be able to suicide on the point. Whereas the other scout will be. Also, try to make your way to the medic and get healed. Scouts and demo men are what win last pushes. Don't die running around by yourself. Try and get to the medic or have it planned that the medic will come to you. Because you and the demo man are the most important people on this last push after the Ubers are over. So now we're going to talk about the roamer on last. If Ubers are equal, do not come in the fight until it has been called that Ubers are over. If you have full advantage, you may bomb their combo if they're in the back with your pocket. In that case, you're going to jump on them and then use your last rocket that you've got in your gun to jump away and go somewhere away from the enemy team so that you can get the chance to reload. Or they're going to chase you. You're going to die in that situation, but they'll chase you. And that's going to take a lot of pressure off of your medic and pocket. And so that'll be good in general. You're doing what you need to do. If it's such that you're coming in late, spam rockets at their medic from clear in the back. Hurt people are going to be running to him or her and to get heals, and you may just get an easy pick. The same thing goes for the spawn doors. If you see anybody breaking to run into spawn to go get resupply cabinet, then shoot rockets at them. And even if they're like 30 or 40 damage spam rockets, that may be enough to get easy kills. Then you're basically just going to slowly push forward. It's the opposite of what you usually do as a roamer, where you're bombing in and stuff. But in this case, it's so much easier to just stand back and spam rockets at people. You can jump in on people. In that case, you'd want to jump in on a demo that's close to the point or things of that nature. Or a heavy, you're going to have to spam. Engineer, you're going to have to spam. Things like that. As pocket on last, your goal is always to do as much damage as you possibly can. If they don't have Uber yet, then you're going to want to focus their medic just to avoid the opportunity for them to get Uber at any point during your fight. If it's Uber v Uber, you're going to be the only person getting Ubered. It's going to be a solo Uber. Force the enemy to pop their Uber by way of either A, getting kills. So you're going to push in away from their combo and kill whoever's in that area with your 300 health. And pop Uber when you get to be unsafe as far as health goes. Or B, the more common option, you just jump on their medic with your Uber and then force them to flash a bunch by damaging anybody you can. Don't waste rockets shooting at an Ubered target. After the Ubers are over, drop to the point and die, thus saving one of your scouts from having to do it. You should say this is what you're going to do. Or jump around to take pressure off of your medic. Or just try and damage anybody who isn't Ubered around you and also call that your Uber is over. Essentially, all the pocket's trying to do is negate their Uber, because when you fight on a last, you're going to have to pop before they pop. In 9 times out of 10. So you need to shorten their Uber by making them flash, or make it less effective by killing lots of people. So it's really up to you, and that's a situational read on your part as the pocket. So now we're going to talk about medic pushing last. If they have a sniper, just don't look at him. Pretend he's not there. Pop when you want to pop. If you get dropped by the sniper, things happen. Congratulations to them for running a sniper. In general, it shouldn't be that big of a deal. if you know that he sees you, as in you've looked at him, you probably want to pop right about then, or you're going to die. You should avoid flashing unless it's absolutely necessary. A big mistake that a lot of teams make is you're going to have some guy standing close to the door. They debt the sticky trap on you, and you flash Uber onto that guy anyways. Don't do that. Don't flash Uber unless you absolutely have to, because they already are going to have a longer Uber than you, assuming it's Uber v. Uber. If you know that the advantage is quite large and they're just never going to get it, then don't worry about it. Flash as much as you want to, really, because your invincibility trumps their complete lack of it. Also, after Ubers are over, or as yours is fading, you should seek to find your demo and at least one scout. And that's sort of going to be the combo for the rest of your life on this last. Just tank a scout and a demo, and your demo with heals. Because ideally, someone's going to die on the point, and the demo's going to just easily kill everyone that then has to stand on the point to keep you from winning. And you need him to be alive. The easiest way to do that is to heal him. And then you use a scout because demos are kind of bad at fighting things that are close to them. Plus, if anything gets hurt by the demo and tries to run away, a scout running at them is probably going to have a pretty easy time. As med, you don't want to suicide on the point unless things are going really well. Like your pocket just fragged three people, or they all ran into spawn for who knows why. Then you can die in the sticky trap. But other than that, you're pretty much not going to want to do that. As demo pushing last, even if you're in the Uber, don't get too involved. You don't want to get up in anybody's face, because you're kind of bad as a class in general at fighting people who are up in your face. You exist to spam the point after it's baited by someone other than you, and then if anyone tries to run into spawn, sticky out the doors. That's all you do on last. It's easy, but a lot of the time demos will get too involved and then they're dead. Make sure that your medic knows where you are, or that you've planned it out ahead of time where you're going to be, so that your medic can get to you. You are the king of pushing last and should have kingly heals so as to be able to kill anyone standing on the point, or at least make them not stand on the point anymore because you have 8 stickies and 4 pipes and win the game, essentially. This is the time for you to win the game for your team. Now I'm just going to talk about some tips and tricks for pushing last in general. If they've run an engineer, try and kill the gun before you push in. Essentially, what will precipitate your push is you killing the gun, because they're not going to be able to set another one up, and that engineer is going to have to switch class. Always, always, always check for traps in any imaginable location. Always assume that there's a trap. Unless you know for a fact that all the stickies are on the point, assume there's a trap everywhere. If they have a heavy, kill him first. The heavy must be the first person to die. Don't let him survive forever and whittle you all down with his 5 damage shots from the back, or 30 plus damage shots right in his face. Also, if you're a soldier, don't jump a heavy. Never, ever, ever, ever jump at a heavy. He will shred you. If they have a sniper, don't look at him. Avoid being in his sight lines. As soon as you pop your Uber, he has to switch class. If they have a pyro, make sure you lead with a scout so that he can't do anything. And if they choose to Uber him, then just kill everyone else who isn't the pyro, because he can't defend last particularly well. And he's not going to have any ammo, so they've just lost the game for themselves. And that's my rough guide to pushing process last. So I hope you've enjoyed. Feel free to comment below with any suggestions, or if you're having problems in your own games pushing process last, I'll try and get back to you as quickly as I can.